Point of today's talk, I would like to give you a bit of intro on what Vibe and Shadow are doing on our Shadow platform, especially on React Native. And what's, you know, all the things always point on the same day. For example, yesterday and today, we are also sponsoring a React Europe conference in Paris. And that's where the most of the Shadow team is, so I'm here all myself, hope you don't mind. And we are, I mean, what we are doing actually is making a huge bet on React Native. But let me give you a whole story. So first, who are we? Just a brief intro. So we are two companies, Five as an agency and Shadow as a product. We together employ 125 people in Zagreb, New York, Osijek, Split even. And we're focusing on mobile. Shoutem is the main purpose of this talk today, and Shoutem has been with us, I think, 6 years now. In these 6 years, we've managed to grow the platform, grow the team, grow the revenues. And right now, we are pretty happy where we are, but we see a huge, huge obstacle ahead. And we see that in the whole mobile space, and that's what I would like to talk today. So far, we've built around 5,000 apps on Shoutem, not us directly, but our clients. And we've learned a lot. Five, on the other hand, is focused on building custom apps. So we're, you know, in the long tail, we are targeting those small number of customers with big budgets. And just something that came out recently, a new app for Rosetta Stone that we published maybe 2 weeks ago, which we're really proud of. And if you're learning languages, you should definitely download our latest project. In any case, we've learned a lot from our clients. And these clients are a respectable bunch, and so this is what we want to use to build the next generation of mobile platforms. So, 8 years ahead, 5,100 plus apps later, this is what we've learned. First of all, there's a lot of repetitive steps in building a mobile product. A lot of that stuff is boring. Where is the real innovation? I mean, when I signed up to be a developer, I wanted to build stuff. I wanted to, you know, invent new interfaces, invent new functionalities, code stuff. I didn't want to waste my time on updating SDKs, on managing the integrating the next release of, I don't know, local database, which I met yesterday, so, or any other SDK. So I don't want to be spending a day building out 50 apps and submitting them to the App Stores or Google Play. I don't want to do that. I want to develop stuff. Second of all, what we've learned, you know, most of our projects, this project typically take quite a long time. No matter, I mean, we always say 4 months, 5 months, a typical project, but it's typically 6 months from the day we meet to the day that the app is published. And it's sometimes even more. And what we've seen across over the years, I mean, I'll give a really complete example. There's one client who has spent last year maybe 100K on no new functionalities, on just fixing bugs. We've inherited the code, we started working on it, they spent 100K of their budget on just fixing bugs. No new stuff, no anything, just maintenance. Nothing new. And this is what was a huge problem. Okay, maybe some clients have the budget, but this will run out. This is not a sustainable thing. There's not enough time spent on the actual innovation that users are expecting. And they're always expecting more. There was this interesting Forrester research saying that only 25% of the apps are updated frequently enough to keep up with the user expectations. Users are always expecting more. And this was published in March 2015 by Forrester. So there's a huge gap. The apps for, you know, apps are really expensive. Why? I mean, there are a lot of my friends here probably in the audience with the same problem as me, that's finding people. I've seen a lot of exhibitors here recruiting. Everyone's trying to find developers because there's not an abundance of iOS, Android for backend developers. We're all, you know, it's pretty limited, especially iOS and Android, which are pretty specialized and require a specific set of skills. And what else? I mean, what I really believe, what's happened with web over the past 15 years will soon happen with mobile. There's a lot of technologies coming out. And now the web agencies who've been doing great stuff in the 2000s are basically struggling for business because people are buying WordPress sites for $10, buying Squarespace sites for $10, which look awesome. And this is what's going to happen with mobile as well. This commoditization, there's a whole lot of technologies out there which are making lives easier. So, what's my thing is, what can we do about it? How can we beat that wave and You know, how can we do something about it, not just stand beside, watch, and take clients' budgets and build super beautiful apps for 100K? That's fine. But what we really want to do is change the market around. We currently have Shoutout. So this is our platform, 6 years in the making. And six months ago, we started the whole revamp of the platform. We spent quite some time investigating, you know, what are our choices. We've seen a couple of things. So first thing is that the platform wasn't extendable enough. Second of all, it was too proprietary. Third of all, we were targeting, the look and feel of the apps wasn't as beautiful as those native apps that, for example, Five is doing. So there was a huge gap between those two ranges. Of course, Shoutout apps cost like $50 a month. You can't beat that with a price when you compare it with a budget of 100K. But still, $50 a month, people expect something that looks really, really good. So what's the idea? What do we want to do, and how do we want to do that? First of all, we want to, you know that 80-20 thing where there's people spending 80% of their time on maintenance and 20% on innovation? In any IT project, you can find those stats. You know, whatever niche of IT you look at. So this is what we want to change in mobile as well. And this is what we see through our internal stats as well in Five. I mean, 80% of our time isn't new features. It's maintaining, bug fixing, those boring stuff, which is, okay, they're billable, but that's not something that excites the end users, nor the clients. So our goal, what we want to really achieve, is help Shoutout maintain that 80%. So Shoutout should take care of the whole platform thing. I'll tell you how later. What we want to do is leave the developers to code that top 20%. How do they want to do it? So one wants to go ahead, and that's it. So just code the stuff that you need to and go live. No questions asked, no fiddling with the platform, no fixing bugs. You just code the things that you need to do. And how we want to do that? We want to do that with the help of React Native framework. How many of you have heard about React Native? How many of you have used React Native?
Okay, let me remember those faces. Too faithful. Okay.
So the thing is, React Native is just for the rest of this, it's a Facebook framework for building native apps. And it's really related to React.js, JavaScript framework. So basically, the skill set behind the React Native framework is JavaScript. And it was a huge, huge battle internally. I mean, what we evaluated was building our proprietary framework that we had so far, looked on Cordova, PhoneGap, which looked like a hybrid app. Or go the other way around and build completely native apps, iOS and Android. But then, I'm not sure how well we could fight that $100 price range or $50 price range if we have to have like two teams, each of them building iOS and Android apps. So we evaluated a couple of frameworks, and React Native came out pretty strongly. I mean, it was. I didn't believe it until maybe 2 days ago. I was still pretty, uncertain that the choice that we made wasn't maybe the right choice, that we made it a way too huge bet. But I'll show you later what happened in the past 2 days. So the mission, what we want to use React Native for, is to save people from boring work. I mean, there's a lot of steps in mobile app development that could be automated. There are things that basically we shouldn't do anymore. That's past that. I mean, why would we be able? I mean, this is the thing that junior guys are doing in most companies. Just to name a few: building apps, publishing apps, updating SDKs. All those stuff that's getting boring. We're losing our top developers because they want to build something new. No one wants to maintain the app after it's being published. I mean, they want to work on a new project. And that's exactly what we want to do. There are a couple of problems that we solved along the way. First of all, automated build and publish. I mentioned that. We had several projects where we built like 50 or 100 flavors of the app and published them to the App Store. And it typically takes, just the build process on Android takes like over 3 hours. And then manual submitting to the App Store and everything.
It's a pain. It's a huge pain.
And Shoutout basically solved that problem just automating the whole thing. Pulling in the source of GitHub, pulling the SDKs, pulling the certificates, doing the automated build, and publishing automatically to the app stores, just with one click. So this is part of Shoutout already today that helped us basically build out those 5,000 apps. Because if you recall, I mentioned that we have 5,000 apps in the app stores, and we update them quarterly, which would mean that updating 5,000 apps quarterly without the automated system would be, again, like two people employed. But
So that's what we want to avoid.
So this is one of the things that the new platform is helping us build. Second of all, integrating and updating SDKs. For example, there's an update of a certain SDK that you're using, whether that's, for example, Layer or Realm or, I don't know, Google Analytics, Shopify, whatever it is, there's a new update. We typically spend like maybe half a day doing the regression test, testing everything, and this should be actually part of the platform. You should actually just be able to click, say, I want this SDK, I want this, this, and this, just put it in and just I don't want to worry about it. And we'll update it and we'll take care of it and just, you can forget about it. Adding new SDKs, switching SDKs. I mean, we have clients using like 30 and 40 and 15 SDKs just for tracking and ads and stuff like that. And managing that, again, that's how they got to that 100K budget without doing anything smart on top of that. Third, which is really important, and now we're tapping into React Native, is updating the UI. We're expecting a lot more design changes in the mobile app space. New material stuff, iOS 10 bringing some great new things. But we've been through that path several times before. And it doesn't have to be something that's related to the mobile platform. It can be just something related to the brand. For example, your brand decided to change its theme, change its color. So what do you need to do as a mobile developer? You have to go into the code, go to the design, redesign everything, and publish and republish stuff. But luckily, through React Native, we can do reusable and scalable components. We can do something like CSS, JSX in React Native, that basically enables us to just specify a component and just update them in one place across all the apps and just do a new theme across all apps and just like layering over a new skin. It's something that's built into React Native that we haven't been able to tap in before. We maybe did with CSS and HTML5 apps, but in React Native, this is like out of the box. So basically, you're building apps using styles. So this is like down there, this is a JSX declaration heading, like a simple declaration that we're using. Second of all, for example, the navigation bars that can be used. So this is just using components out of the React Native space. There's a whole lot of things already built in there, which we want to avoid having to build on our own. We want to skin these things, we want to make them look beautiful, we want to reuse them in the app, but I don't want to be building a new navigation drawer or whatever. I don't want to be doing that. I don't want to be building lists and those controls. I want to reuse stuff and build something on top of that. What I want to really do is to be able to publish an app within a month from the first day that I meet a client. And I want this app to look beautiful, and I want to be able to republish the app with a new design within a week after that. And that's the ultimate goal. And this is, you know, what drew us to that. A lot of components, a lot of things that can be reused just because of React Native has this separation of things similar to HTML that we can reuse and build native apps. And this is really important, building native apps. So there are no drawbacks, there are no setbacks. This is the result with React Native is purely native. And fourth thing, as a mobile developer, I want to really focus on mobile. Most of our projects have some backend work to be done. They have something like CMS. This is irrelevant for me as a mobile developer. This is something that ideally I would just buy, click, and just forget about it. With Shoutem, we've always done that. For example, in the $50 price range, you get that Shoutem cloud. You get the Shoutem CMS. You get that analytics stuff in there. So that was already built into the platform and it worked. So where does this magic kick in? So this is like so you remember those close 20%? How do we do that? The key are extensions. So the extensions which are part of our platform. So I'll give you just a small thing. So you can use like a bunch of the components that are already in the platform, but you can build your own component. And what we're doing right now is working with agencies, again, such as Five, as we are being our own dog food client's biggest testers. We're working with several agencies who are building their vertical competencies on Shoutem. For example, there are agencies who are building their own extensions, their own components just for the event space. There's one agency building their component just in the retail space, in the e-commerce space, building their components just in that range. And this is the top 20% that I'm talking about. So there's like 80% of the apps
is the same. Login, registration, caching, screen, about screens, news, events, this is all common. And you can scan it, you can change it, look and feel, but what's your real advantage? It's your vertical niche knowledge. As I said, so we have some couple of apps, one which I'll show you later, just built for events, with some specific stuff built for events. And this is the ownership of that agency where they're building their competence on. In Shadow, we have a bunch of components already done, and most importantly, they're open source. So anyone can build their own component, they can sell their component, they can look into the other components, they can extend any of the existing components. So it's not that you can take the existing component, work on it, redo it, rebuild it, add maybe just a tiny button and republish it. I mean, there are a bunch of apps who look similar, and that's exactly what we want to avoid. You can use the template-based engine, for example, for the audio player, but each radio station, if I can give you a concrete example, has some specifics on that audio player. For example, which song is currently playing. And to be able to do that, what you just need to do, take the player extension and just add a tiny bit of code that connects to your server or wherever you pull the data from, and display the data below there. It's like a two-hour thing. Another week or two-week thing. That's exactly the idea. So we have 20 extensions, including the source code, available on Shard Marketplace. You can build your own, or you can use those. And most importantly, again, coming back to React Native, is reusing the existing JavaScript skills. So we had a nice discussion yesterday. I don't know which developers are easier to build up and find or hire or whatever. And we're struggling with, of course, with native iOS and Android developers. We have a bunch of them, and they're great. And this is the skills that we want to build in the future. But we want to extend that and have JavaScript web guys who have been working in JavaScript for years now, and now to be able to build beautiful native apps, that's what we're betting on React Native. And native UI performances. So there's this demo that I made last night. Because, just another thing, we're currently in beta. We are presenting yesterday and today on React Europe, and we plan to go live in September, October timeframe. Up until then, we're building apps with clients. We have several apps already built. We have new partnerships coming up. But we'll be live in after the summer. So let me show you what I mean by native experiences. So just, again, clarification, this is a React Native app built 2 days ago, that is built in JavaScript and on top of Shadow. So Shadow is providing, like maybe, Shadow is actually 100% this functionality. We haven't extended it whatsoever. So what you see here is like core Shadow functionality. But what I really want you to pay attention to is the native look and feel. I've been in the industry for 8 years now, and I can't tell the difference between a hybrid app and an I could have always told the difference between a hybrid app, JavaScript, HTML5 app, and a native app. You can just tell. Let me show you. So this is, pay attention to the transitions that React Native does. Pay attention to the sliding, to the parallax effect that can be done with the platform. This looks and feels native, and it's built completely in JavaScript. And what's more important, you can take any of those components and extend it to your JavaScript code. How many of you know JavaScript? Much more than React Native, but it's a small gap to cross. It's a small gap to cross to be able to build native apps. This is what I wanted to show today. So this is our huge bet that we're making as a company, where we believe that building platforms and products is the way, obviously, to go. But we see a huge gap between those 100K budget apps that Fiverr is doing and those $1,000 app that Shadow is doing. There's a huge gap in between that can be closed with a smooth and nice platform. If you want more details, I'll be available later on to show you all the details within the app. As I said, all of our tech team is currently in Paris working with Facebook guys. We got some great reviews there yesterday. We got some meetings directly with Facebook guys because this is their version 0.24, so 0.24, so they're really early stage. And the platform and it really looks ready for the production. And that's what we're doing with Shadow, and that's what I would like to invite you to try out as well. If you're interested,
go to shoutout.github.io, sign up for the beta. You can look at the whole documentation is already up there. We're trying to be transparent as possible. Our whole process has been done by writing the documentation first, testing it out, and then implementing it in the code. So if you're interested, if you want to build up your React Native skills and build those apps, you can go shoutout.github.io and sign up for the beta and get early access as soon as it's available. Thank you for your attention.